Number six, water. Oh my god, if you didn't know, yeah, honey, drink water, mind your business, because water makes up 60% of your body. 60%. Your body is made up of 60% of water, so you need to make sure that you're drinking enough water. An adult recommended amount of water to drink in a day for a man is 3.7 liters, and for a woman is 2.7 liters. So make sure that you're having that much water every single day. It's difficult sometimes if you don't like actual H2O water, but you can probably drink tea as a way to make sure that you're getting all the liquids that your body needs. So you can obviously, again, like I said earlier, moderation is good for everything. So make sure that you're not having too much caffeine than required every single day. You know that you need 2.7 liters as a woman of water every single day. So maybe in one tea bag, you can have like this massive, gigantic mug to make sure that in that one tea bag you're getting as much water as possible, if you get what I mean. Number seven, supplements. Like I said earlier, when I talked about healthy meals, and I said you should make sure that you're eating a balanced diet. I know that sometimes it's difficult for you to actually eat a meal that contains all the nutrients that you need. So this is where supplements come in. Supplements help you to complete that. Just so you know, supplements are not, they are like additives. So they're not made for you to take them instead of having an actual meal. They are additives to your meal. So make sure that you're eating 3 times a day and also having your supplements, because they add on to that and make sure that you're getting all the nutrients that your body needs. So don't skip a meal and have a supplement instead. That's not recommended. That's not what supplements is used for. Okay. Number eight, cut out smoking. If you're a smoker, let me motivate you from this video to cut out smoking, because smoking can cause you cancer. So it increases your chance of getting cancer. Smoking increases your chance, or can cause you to get respiratory issues like asthma or COPD. Smoking can cause you, or increases your chance of having a stroke. Smoking can cause you, or increases your chance of having heart diseases. So there's so many reasons. These are like reasons for you to think about it today and stop smoking. When I say can cause you or increases your chances, it's because some of this, some diseases are actually like genetically related. But if it's not genetically related, then smoking can actually cause you to have those diseases. So that's why I say can cause you or increases your chances of having these diseases. So try as much as possible to stop smoking. I know it's a difficult thing to do because obviously it's a habit, but there's ways to get around it. And I have a post in which I wrote earlier this year to help you. If your goal is to stop smoking, I would be linking that in the description box. So the post basically just gives you tips on how to make sure that you achieve your goal if your goal is for a certain thing, and I used smoking as an instance in that post. So make sure you do check that out if you are interested in finding out more. So, and again, smoking costs you a lot of money. So a pack of cigarettes is probably like £12. And let's say, for the purpose of this video, that you smoke 2 packets of cigarettes in a week, because I know some people smoke more than that. So, but let's say you smoke 2 packets of cigarettes in a week. That's £24 that you spend on cigarettes every week. That is £96 that you spend on cigarettes every month. That is £1,152 that you're spending on cigarettes every year. £1,152. Think about what you can do with £1,152 that you, if you have saved that money. Think about what you could have done with it. That's if you're trying to buy a house, that's like £1,000 less that you have to save. £1,000 that you're spending every year on cigarettes, on something that is not good for your health, and something that is not good for you. So if it's enough motivation, just what I've just said, as motivation for you to stop smoking. And make sure you do check out that video, I mean that post that I talked about earlier. If you're a smoker and you really want to stop smoking, because it is possible, it's just a matter of time. So you start small, start by cutting down and cutting down and cutting down and cutting down, and before you know it, you will stop smoking. So yeah, that's that tip. Number 9, cut down on alcohol intake. Like, one kind of beer can contain like maybe 150 to 200 calories, and that again is probably like a breakfast for you, you know, but you're just taking that in like just for leisure purposes. And imagine if you do this every day, on top of your actual meal, you're just having like 150 calories. Yeah, try as much as possible to cut down alcohol. And again, it can cause your liver issues as well, and it's a central nervous system depressant. It causes depression for you, it depresses your central nervous system, and that means it depresses your brain. Your brain is part of the central nervous system. Imagine drinking alcohol every single day. You're basically just depressing your brain every single day, and that is not good, obviously. So try as much as possible to cut down alcohol intake. Number 10, self-care. So when I say self-care, I'm not talking about just masking, pampering yourself and going for a massage and all that stuff. I'm talking about emotional self-care, I'm talking about physical self-care, I'm talking about spiritual self-care, and I'm also talking about social self-care. I have a post on self-care, I will be linking that down in the description box, so make sure you do check that out as well. Make sure that you're taking care of yourself, both physically by, like, let's say all those masks and massage and all of that stuff, socially by hanging out with friends and stuff like that, spiritually reading your Bible, doing things to increase your spiritual growth, and emotionally make sure that you're cutting out negativity and all of that stuff. Number 11, take out time. If you're stressed, if you're feeling stressed, or you sort of feel stressed, just take time out and relax and chill and take care of yourself and de-stress and do something that you love. Travel, hang out with friends, do whatever it is to help you relieve that stress. Because stress is not good for you. It can cause you headaches, it can cause you sleepless nights, and like I said, you need to be getting a lot of sleep, because obviously you don't want to get old. Stress can cause you headaches. Stress can also cause you to have a lot, like, low energy, so you literally have no energy for anything. And it can also cause you things like diarrhea. You might not know that, but it can cause you like all this kind of stuff. So make sure that you're not stressed at all. Number 12, stay positive. Whatever it is that is not positive in your life, cut it out. Cut it out. Bring my lip. Cut it out. Whatever it is, friends, cut it out. People, cut it out. Social media, cut it out. Whatever it is that literally does not bring you positive energy, because you need positive energy. And if anything is bringing you negative energy at all times, just literally be like, bye. Like literally just stay wherever you are. Like, don't come this way, okay? If you don't have positive energy, you can fall into depression, and we already know that depression is not a good thing, because it can cause other stuff apart from depression. It can cause people to commit suicide. So if you don't have any positive energy around you, you only have negative energy for people around you or for whatever it is around you, you literally just dispose whatever it is. Dispose it. Number 13, meditate. So like I said earlier, meditation is a form of self-care, is a form of, I probably didn't say that earlier, but meditation is a form of self-care, is a form of emotional self-care or spiritual self-care, because it helps you to be self-aware, it helps you to stay focused, it relieves stress, and it also relieves anxiety. So if you're stressing, you are anxious, one way to definitely help yourself there is to meditate. Number 14, do what you love. Guys, I cannot overemphasize this, but if you wake up every morning and you literally feel like dying because you don't like the job that you are in, I'm telling you, look for a new one. Try and get out of there as soon as possible, because being in that job will cost you nothing but stress. And like I already said earlier, what stress can cause you, and also, it's not good for your mental, it's not good for your mental state, it's not good for your, it's not good for your emotional well-being, because you're gonna be constantly stressed out. You probably could fall into depression because of how much you hate that job. So I know obviously sometimes that we do stuff that sometimes we wake up in the morning and we're not feeling 100%. And I know that sometimes we do stuff because we have no other choice, but as much as possible, try to do what you love. And if you don't love what you're doing, try to get out of it quick. And the last tip is hang out with friends. Get a social life. If you don't have one, please get a social life. Do you have a social life? If you don't have one, then get one. Surround yourself with people that will love you. Surround yourself with people that would care for you. Surround yourself with people that bring you positive energy. People that you can count on. People that you can rely on. People that can help you. People that you can gist with. People that you can travel with. You can hang out with. You can go out and eat. You know, you can go for a walk with. Or you can stay on the phone with and gist for a long time. Surround yourself with those kind of people. Have a social life. So your life shouldn't be all about just work. Oh, money. I understand that it's essential for us to make money, because obviously money is important for us to live in this world, because everything is kind of like governed by money. But at the same time, try to look after yourself emotionally and socially by getting a social life, by having friends, and not just go to work, come back, binge watch Netflix, go to sleep, wake up the next morning, go to work, come back, Netflix, and that's it. Have friends. Obviously, I know as adults, it's difficult to make friends, but if you don't have one, try to make one. Okay. All right, that's it for this video. This is the end of this video. I hope you liked it. So give it a thumbs up if you did. If you didn't, then give it a thumbs down and let me know why you didn't like it, so that I can obviously take tips. Make sure you check out this two posts that I talked to you guys about on how to ensure that you achieve your goals, and also on self-care. Is there anything that you're already incorporating that I talked about? Tell me in the comment section. Is there anything that I missed out and you think it's an easy way for people to live a healthy lifestyle? Please also let me know in the comment section. And if there is anything that you would like, that you would be taking from this video and you would be incorporating it into your normal daily routine, also let me know in the comment section. Anyways, that's it for this video, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Oh, make sure that you subscribe, and make sure that you're liking, and make sure that you comment it, and you share it with your friends and your mom and your dad and your friends and everybody. Okay, I love you guys.